Hi friends, how's it going? It's me, Betty Jean. Today I'm here to do my February Ipsy and Sephora Play Unbagging with you. I'm gonna talk about the products, kind of my first initial thoughts seeing them. If you have any questions regarding like any kind of follow-up on how I felt about the products, of course you can ask, leave it down below, we can chit-chat about it. I love to talk to you guys. I will also have all of the products and their prices for the full-size item, whether I get the full-size or I got the sample, they're usually samples. I'll have all that listed down below if you're interested. I want to do it a little bit differently this time too. I think at the end of the video I want to kind of compare and see which bag I feel like is better that month. Of course the Ipsy bag varies. I think Sephora Play stays relatively the same amongst everybody, but I still want to just kind of battle them out at the end and see which bag kind of won this month in my opinion. So without further ado, let's just get going. So this is the Ipsy bag this month. I think it's super cute and girly and glamorous. I love the black lace. I think it's so pretty. Little card that came in the bag, it just says unzipped, and then there's always a little blurb about everything on the back. Not gonna read it because I honestly just don't feel like it. The first thing I got that didn't fit in this bag but it was still in the package was the 5-minute facial mask with tea tree oil, rosehip extract, and vitamin C. Enhances radiance, minimizes pores, even skin tone. It is from the brand Biobelle. So it looks like this is a sheet mask that's meant to be a primer for your skin before makeup. Clean your skin, put it on, leave the mask on for 5 minutes, and your skin should be primed and good to go. Oh, it comes with two. That's cool. I love sheet masks. I love when Ipsy sends two sheet masks kind of as one thing. It's happened to me a few times and I love it. So we'll see how this works. I'm intrigued. Next I have a Luxie 249 brush. It's a dual ended. This one's more of an eyeshadow side than this is more of a blending side. They're one of my favorite brush brands. It feels super soft. I love the way they look, but the gold and the pink, it's so pretty. I'm really excited about this. I love getting brushes in my subscription boxes. Next up we have this Luna by Luna highlight. Is the shade Luna? Okay, the shade's Electra. Ooh, that's promising. Ooh, that's pretty. I like it. It's very soft and subtle, not too glittery, which I love glittery highlighters, but I also can get down with a soft and subtle highlighter. That is gorgeous. I like it. Next, I have the It Cosmetics Bye Bye Undereye Concealer, and they sent me the shade Light Ultra Fair, which is good because I am ultra fair. I think I've used this in the past, if I'm not mistaken. I think I got a sample many, many moons ago. I think I liked it. Very full coverage, very thick, very creamy, and that color will work perfectly. I'm excited to get a concealer that actually matches me. That's cool. And last, I have this matte liquid lip paint from the brand Mellow in the shade Tehran, T-E-H-R-A-N. I'm gonna assume that's Tehran. It looks just like a really pretty brown-based nude, and that's my favorite. It's cute. It's kind of sheer, but I don't hate that. It feels very lightweight. I'll wear it. I'll see if it works good. I like the color, so that's already a plus. That was the 5 things from my Ipsy bag, and I like everything, actually. I know I'm gonna like the concealer, the brush, and I'm probably gonna like the highlighter. The only things that may or may not work are the lipstick and the mask, and I'm excited to try them, so I think this month was a win-win as long as everything works good. Let's jump into the Sephora Play bag. On the front, it says Feel the Love. It's cute. With their bags, they always have a big paper with them as well, including a little card for 50 free beauty insider points at Sephora. I like that these look like old-timey carnival tickets. It's so cute. And then on the back, there's going to be information on all the products that are inside, but I'm not going to read it because I don't want to be spoiled. Usually Sephora Plays has 5 samples as well, and then a 6th perfume sample, although last month I didn't get perfume and I got just a regular beauty sample, which I preferred. First things first is this Sephora Cream Lip Stain in the shade Always Red. I don't think I've ever had a Sephora Play box where I didn't get a red lipstick, but at least this is a liquid lipstick, although this is the tiniest sample I've ever seen from Sephora. It feels nice. It's a pretty red. Do I already have plenty of red liquid lipsticks? Yes, but at least it's not a regular lipstick, because red regular lipstick, I can't do without making a big mess. This is Flowerbomb by Viktor Rolf. I'm sorry if I said that wrong. I'm not perfume savvy. It's very light. It's florally. I can't decide if it's too florally for me or not, though. We'll see how it wears. First impression, I'm not the biggest fan. Next, I got this Lancôme Monsieur Big Mascara. Love this kind of wand where it's like fat and feathered out really nice. This is my kind of wand. Next, I got this Belif Moisturizing Eye Balm. I'm excited about this. I had the Clinique Pep Star Eye Cream last month and I just finished it. And I like the brand Belif. I've used a couple of their moisturizing products before, so I'll give this a shot and I'll see how it goes. So far, this is the most exciting thing in the bag. Next, I got from the brand First Aid Beauty this Ginger and Tumeric Vitamin C Jelly Mask. What are you supposed to do? All it tells me is how to use it. It doesn't say what it's for. Probably hydration if it's got vitamin C, but I mean, I'll try it. We'll see how it goes. Wow, another lipstick. Another Sephora brand lipstick at that. And I'm pretty sure it's red. Oh, and it's all like smushed on the top. I don't know if you can see that. It's all smushed. Ew, I do not like that. It's very waxy feeling. No, I don't like that one bit. I'm not even gonna try to use that. That's disgusting. Should probably at least tell you what it is in case you were curious. It doesn't even say. It's on the box. It's the Sephora Rouge Matte Lipstick in the shade Rebel Chic. I don't think we have to think too hard to know that Ipsy definitely won this month, in my opinion. Honestly, the only thing I'm excited to use is the Belif Eye Balm. Yes. Super, super excited for Ipsy, not so excited for Sephora Play, so there you have it. I feel like I ran through that pretty quick. I just didn't have a whole lot of thoughts about everything. I either loved it or I wasn't really interested. But if you are subscribed to either of these subscription boxes, let me know what you got. Let's talk about our things. Did you get better things than me in the Sephora Play box? Did we get the same thing? Same with Ipsy. Did you get better things than me? What did you get? I want to know. Down below, I will have my Ipsy referral link posted in case you wanted to click on that if you wanted to sign up. All it does is gives me more Ipsy points so I can redeem them for more samples. Sephora Play, I'll have it linked down as well. Doesn't mean anything to me, just makes it a little bit easier for you. If you like these Sephora Play Ipsy Unbaggings, give me a thumbs up so I know to keep making more. If you're not already, please go to my Instagram, it's ButteBean, and follow me there. I post every single day, and don't forget to subscribe here before you leave. I post every 3 days. Let me know what videos you're interested in seeing next month. I think that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Okay, bye! I have no clue what's in my Sephora. One of my favorite lash brands. This is not lashes. So that was everything from, ooh, I'm smearing my swatches all over my legs. I can't believe I got two Sephora brand red lipsticks in the same box.